wisconsingarden.com. Back a few years ago when we just started and we were wisconsingarden.net, we did about 300 videos, and in the very early ones, some of our visitors said that they had difficulty understanding what I was saying, hearing. And so Rick, as his learning curve has improved and his talents have increased, decided that he would go back and redo them to enhance their quality. This is one of those videos. We hope you enjoy it. Give us a thumbs up if you've learned something and can appreciate them. Bye. Hello, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.org. And today, it's Saturday morning. It's Farmer's Market Day. There's only three left for the whole summer, and then it's done until spring. So I begged, and my husband said, sure, let's go. And what did we find but apples? I wasn't about to buy apples today, but when we got to the farmer's market, we were talking to the woman about her apples and what kind I should use to make applesauce. She said, you're always best using a variety of apples because the flavors mingle and it's much tastier. So she also suggested that we use apples that are called seconds or drops, the ones that fall off the tree that aren't picked. So they're not as beautiful as the ones that you would buy in the store or if you would get them at a farmer's market. Some of them have little bruises on them. Some are misshapen. Some are a little smaller. Some have little spots. None of that matters when you're making applesauce. So these were perfect, and they're about half the price, a third to a half of the price as you would pay for the perfect apples. So you're going to squish them up anyway. Who is going to see them? So we loaded up, got our 10 bags, $3 a bag, so do the math. We thought it was a pretty good deal, and it's going to be so delicious in the winter. Then the next step is to wash them, because they've been outside, figure. They've had poison on them. People have touched them. They've fallen on the ground. They've been in boxes. So you want to wash them. I like to put just a drop or two of dish detergent in there just because it helps the soil come off better, and you're going to rinse them anyway, so it doesn't matter. I also like to scrub where the stem is and where the blossom end is, because that's where the majority of the dirt is going to be. And then as you get them done, just rinse them off. After that stage, you go to the next stage, which is quartering. Leave the skin on. Many people just do this. They take it, they quarter it, they throw it in the pot. I like to take off the very edge where the stem would be, because that's where poison would settle in if there was any residual poison. Then you toss it in the pot. And you do that until your pot is nearly full, because they will cook down. Put in about an inch of water. Could be an inch of apple juice if you have apple juice. And you're going to keep them. You're going to cook them until they're mushy. Mushy that you can stir them and the skins are falling off and you see seeds floating around in there and you're thinking, ugh, this is awful. But then comes the next step when you put it through what's called a Foley mill. A Foley mill is a crank, and I'll bring it out later. But you take your apple mush, you put it in the Foley mill, you put the Foley mill over another pan, and you crank it by hand until all of the apple pulp is now in the bottom, and the seeds and the stems and all those little fingernail kind of things on the seed case are up in the Foley mill. Back, stir it, throw that in your compost. Once you have a pot of lovely applesauce, you're going to sweeten it a little bit with some sugar if you feel it needs sweetening. If you like to put cinnamon in, you put cinnamon in, and you cook it, and you bring it to not quite a boil, so it's just really hot. From that point, you put it into your warm jars, and then you put your jars into a water bath. Just like canning tomatoes, except now it's applesauce, even better. So I will continue coring and cooking, and show you the next step with the folding mill. This is how high you can fill the pot, right to the brim. And then remember to put about an inch of water or apple juice in the bottom, and then cover. Every now and again, stir them up, and you'll see that as they cook, they mush down. So medium heat, just keep an eye on them. Don't put them on and then walk away. But you don't need to keep stirring. Stirring the steam will help reduce the muscle. Here we are. Our apples have now cooked down. Remember, the apples used to be way up at the top. And we've recruited help for this project. This is our grandson, Logan. Say hi, Logan.
Hi.
And he is going to do the hard part. He is going to turn the foley mill. This is called a foley mill. And what you do is you scoop out your apples now that are all mushy. And there's the skins and there's the seeds. You don't want to eat those. So you put it in the foley mill and then you crank it. It takes muscles to do this. You crank it and crank it. And it smells wonderful in here. It smells like you're on the inside of a caramel apple.
Yeah.
Your whole house smells good.
Uh-huh. It's kind of like people are going to be like running.
They're going to run over here, aren't they, just to eat our apple sauce.
Like they can smell it right through that window.
Probably.
I can see his muscles building already. Look at that.
Yep. And then now and again go backwards to clean off the scrapers in there. And you can see that you're now, see what's left in there? You've got the skins left in there and some seeds, all those things you don't want to eat. Ready for some more?
Yeah.
Okay. Dump some more in there.
Holy cow.
All right, always go clockwise while you're working.
Can you still find that? I almost got it.
You can remember that?
I saw one seed.
Did you?
Yeah.
Let's get that big apple off of there. Wait a minute, that apple is just taking a free ride. Okay. Crank them down. Yep. See how you're mushing them up?
So it's crunchy.
And what a wonderful way for children to figure out where the food comes from in their life. It doesn't just come from a jar. You actually have to prepare it before it goes into the jar.
And the picking process, the growing process, you take it back to a time where people really became more self-sufficient than we are today. We take a lot of things for granted.
Right.
Okay, now.
Okay, should we look at the applesauce that's coming out? Ah, oh, look at that. What wonderful stuff. Oh, it's going to taste so delicious. Ready for some more?
Yep.
Oh, I'm so glad I've got muscles helping me here. I suppose you're going to want to taste it, too. All right, we'll stop with the... Ooh, we'll start with a big pot this time. Oh, and it smells wonderful.
Can you see it, like, right under there? It's like it comes from those tiny holes.
Yep.
See it dripping?
Mm-hmm.
You see me mushing it through. Wasn't that... Man that made this.
Can you see the steam?
Yes, it's hot. Mr. Foley, who invented this little machine here, really had a good idea. He probably helped his mom with applesauce and he said, there's got to be a better way.
Call me Mr. Mixer.
Okay, Mr. Mixer. Doing a good job. After Logan, my Mr. Muscle Man, did all his turning and turning and turning on the foley mill, this is the beautiful applesauce that came about, that pot and this pot. I figured we used about 12 pounds of apples, not quite 3 bags worth. Now, it's the tasting time. Mm-hmm. So we have to taste it to see if it needs any sugar, and then we may want to put some cinnamon in also. So first we're going to taste it. Okay, blow on it because it's really, really hot. Blow, get it nice and cool so you can get a good taste. Does it need some sugar? A whole lot of sugar or just a little? Did it try a little bit first? Okay. Put some sugar in there, maybe that much. That much over here.
Could I help?
Okay, now you gotta stir it up again.
Can I stir it?
Stir away, boy. Stir away.
Could you, like, move the stool?
Okay, jump down. And remember that the fire is on, so we have to be careful because we're working with fire here. Oh, let me turn them off. And these are cool handles, which is nice. And you want to stir that sugar in until it's all dissolved. Do it slowly. Slowly and carefully.
I can feel it going.
Can you feel the grittiness of it?
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. And we have to stir it until all that grittiness goes away.
This guy here?
Not yet. Still at work.
Oh.
Okay. Let's take another taste test. Clean spoon. One last twirl. Blow on it again. Not much, because it's really hot. Careful. All
right. I did it.
That's okay. We'll get it. It's really hot, isn't it? How was that? Good, or does it need a little more?
This is little.
A little bit more?
Yep, just a little.
Okay, like about that much?
Yeah, could I stir it?
Stir it again. And we want to make one batch with cinnamon and one batch without cinnamon, so we'll have to get all the way down to the bottom. We'll do cinnamon on yours. How'd that be?
Yeah, sure.
Then you can watch it go in.
What's that?
Cinnamon.
Oh.
And that's easy to see if you get it all stirred up. That smells even better. It smells like apple pie now.
Yeah.
Round in circles and then make figure eights.
It's like snakes sliding in the sea. Can you hear it so quiet?
I hear it so quiet. We have to taste test again. We need a new spoon.
Like with the cinnamon. The cinnamon's going to taste like very good. But if it doesn't taste good, then you add a little bit more. So Gina tries it.
I should try first.
Okay, and she should blow it, because can you see that steam on her spoon?
I see it. Thanks for reminding me. It is good. You want to taste it? Go on your steam.
Tastes like cinnamon.
Okay, I think we're ready for the next step. I just have to get my jars ready. See you in a minute. My little helper got tired, so he's taking a movie break. But in the meanwhile, we're going to put the applesauce into the bottles. So because this applesauce is boiling hot, you need to have warm bottles to put it in, so that they don't crack when you put the hot sauce in. So you have your sterilized bottles. Put your little funnel in there. And now you're just going to slowly start filling up each bottle with your treasure. And this is the cinnamon batch, so this one smells absolutely wonderful. Taking a mess here. And you're going to fill it until it gets up to that little neck part. Okay. And then the next step is figuring out where you're going to put this. Okay. Then you take a clean part of your towel, wipe off the edges so that there's nothing that'll get between the seal and the jar. You've had these little lids warming up so that the rubber gets soft. You gently place it on top, hold it in place, hold it down, and then screw it on. You don't want to screw it on real tight. You just want to give it a gentle twist. And then that one is ready to go into the water bath. These have to go into a water bath for 20 minutes. And then when you take them out, it'll take from half an hour to a couple of hours, and then you'll know if they sealed. If they still go like this, they make this noise after their 20 minute water bath and they're cooling, you know it didn't work.
If now when you say water bath.
Right. We have a canning kit here, which is the bottom. This is the new kind where you don't have to fill the whole thing up with water like the olden days when you had to fill the whole pan up and immerse the whole jar in. Now they do it with steam. So this will be filled then with water. Takes about 6 cups of water. And I've preheated it just so I don't have to spend all the time waiting for it to heat up. And then you will set this and all its little companions in here. Then there's a big lid that I'm right now using as a bath. The lid goes on and you wait until the water starts boiling before you start timing your 20 minutes. And on this particular thing, there are little holes in the lid, and when the steam shoots out the little hole, about 8 inches long, then you know you can start timing. And you time for 20 minutes, then you get your either your hot pad or your jar puller,
tongs.
And you carefully pull it out, put it on a cloth, make sure it's not touching and you haven't jiggled it, and just let it rest. And eventually you hear a little pop, and then you know it's sealed. So we'll enjoy our applesauce this winter.
How many bags did you use, by the way? We bought, what, 10 bags?
We bought 10 bags. I used a little over two, so maybe 2.5, 2 3/3, 2/3. So I'm going to do this at least twice more. I'm looking forward to it. And then maybe a couple of apple pies or apple kuchens. Bye for now. Almost done. I was referring to the steam poking out of the pan. This is what I meant. There, each canning pan comes with directions of how to do it and what to look for. But this is the steam smoke, or the steam coming out, and that's when you start timing. When it starts shooting out that far, then you start your timer. This is going for 20 minutes. I got 6 quarts of applesauce with a little bowl left. I only made 5 because I think we're going to eat the other one for supper tonight. So that's applesauce, and enjoy it. It's fun. It's potsy, lots of dishes. The bigger your pan that you have, the bigger your pot, obviously the bigger batch you could make and it would go faster. But I don't like to use aluminum pans for this because apples are acidic, so I use my stainless steel. Have fun. Enjoy.